Now he has the parables of the garment and the bottles. Now, actually, this is the first parable we've come to in the gospel. He spake also a parable unto them, no man putteth a piece of new garment upon an old. If otherwise, then both the new maketh a rent, and the piece that was taken out of the new agreeth not with the old. And no man putteth new wine into old bottles, else the new wine will burst the bottles and be spilled, and the bottles shall perish. But new wine must be put into new bottles, and both are preserved. No man also, having drunk old wine, straightway desireth new, for he saith, the old is better. You see, the natural man likes the old wine. He likes the old ways, likes the old religion. But the important thing is we need to recognize our Lord brought something new, and that's the gospel. And he didn't come into the world to do any patching of the old garment. That is, he didn't come to intend to patch up the law. He came to pay the penalty of sin on the cross, and he did more than that. He rose from the dead, and now he places his robe of righteousness, and he gives the new wine of the gospel. But it must be placed in a new wine cask, not in the old one of the law. Be not drunk with wine wherein is excess, but be filled today with the Holy Spirit. That's the message that he gives out today. And he came to give you something new. He came to save you by faith in him. You see, this whole chapter points in one direction. It's moving in one direction. It's to present the glorious gospel of Christ in as many ways as is possible, that men might hear and have an opportunity to choose whether they'll accept Christ or reject him. And that's up to you. But he's still putting new wine in new bottles, and he's still giving new garments and not patching up the old one. Have you accepted him and received him today?